This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about subtracting positive and negative numbers. And I'm going to do this in two ways. I'm going to do a mathematical approach, and I'm also going to show you how it would work if we used a number line. So here's the first problem. Here I've got 5 minus 8. So that's a subtraction problem. What I'm going to do with subtraction problems is turn them into addition problems, and here's how. I'll start out with a 5, and instead of a minus sign, I'm going to use the opposite of the minus sign, which is a plus sign. So instead of 5 minus, I've got 5 plus. Now, I want to compensate for that change, and the way I'll do that is here where I have an 8, the number I was taking away from 5, I'm going to change that 8 into its opposite. I'm going to change that into a negative 8. So I've gone from subtraction to its opposite addition, and I've gone from positive 8 to its opposite negative 8. Now I've got an addition problem, 5 plus negative 8, and I have to add those two numbers together. My basic rule says when the signs are different, I've got one positive and one negative. When the signs are different, I find the absolute value of the two numbers. So it's 5 and 8. And I take the difference of those two absolute values. Well, the difference of 5 and 8 is 3. And then to determine the sign, I use the sign that the bigger of those two numbers had. So the bigger number in terms of absolute value was 8. And that had a negative sign. So that means I'm going to have negative 3. So 5 minus 8 is negative 3. Now we can look at this on a number line as well. This is going to be similar to the way that in a different video we looked at addition on a number line. So let's start here towards the middle with a 0. And I'll add the positive numbers. That means I'm going to move to the right of the 0. Of 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And I'll add negative numbers, which means I'm going from the 0 to the left. So that's negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and negative 5. Now, I'm going to start from the 0. I've got 5 minus 8. So I want to move from 0, 5 units to the right, up to the number 5. Okay, because the 5 was a positive number, I'm starting from 0, and I move to the right for that positive number. Now I want to subtract 8. Well, 8 is also a positive number, but if I'm subtracting, the subtraction means I'm going to take whatever direction I would normally go in and go in the opposite direction. So now I'm going to move 8 units to the left from the 5. So I move back to the left 8 units, and that gets me to negative 3, which is the same number I got by doing this mathematically. Okay? Let's look at a couple more examples. Here's the next one. Here I've got negative 6 minus negative 4. So I'm going to turn this subtraction problem into addition. I'll have negative 6. Instead of minus, I'll have a plus, the opposite of the minus. And instead of negative 4, I'll have the opposite of negative 4, which is a positive 4. So now I've got the addition problem, negative 6 plus 4. The signs are different. So I'll find the difference of the absolute values of those two numbers. Well, that means I'm looking for the difference between 6 and 4. The difference is 2. I need to know what sign I'll use. And the sign is going to be the sign of the larger of the two absolute numbers. The larger of those numbers is 6. So that means I've got negative 2. Okay, let's do a number line. Here's the 0, and I'll write some numbers to the right of it, the positive numbers, 1, 2, and 3. And I'll put in some negative numbers moving to the left, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, and negative 6. Okay, so now, starting from the 0, I've got a negative 6. So that means I want to count back 6 spaces to the left, since the negative numbers move to the left. So that was 6 spaces, and that got me to negative 6. And then I have to subtract negative 4. Well, the negative 4 by itself would tell me to move to the left, but when I subtract, that tells me to go in the opposite direction that I would have if I was adding. So instead of going 4 spaces to the left, which is what the negative 4 would do by itself, I'm going to go 4 spaces to the right. So moving 4 spaces to the right, that gets me to negative 2. Negative 2 is the same number I got before when I did this the other way. Okay, so let's try this with one more. Here I've got negative 3 minus 4. So I'm going to take that subtraction problem and turn it into addition. I'll make that negative 3 plus negative 4. I took the opposite of my subtraction and made it into addition. And I took the opposite of the 4 and made it into negative 4. Now I'm adding negative 3 and negative 4. The signs are the same, so that means all I have to do is make this into negative 7. The answer will be negative. I'll add the 3 and the 4 together. Okay, let's do this one on the number line. So here's a 0. I want to leave plenty of room for my negative numbers, so I'll just put a few positive numbers to the right of the 0. And now I'll put in a negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8. Okay, so I'm starting out with negative 3. I'll go from the 0 to the negative 3. That means I'm moving 3 spaces to the left. And that gets me over to the 3. From the 3, after that negative 3, I've got minus 4. Well, 4 would normally take me to the right, but since it's minus 4, that means I'm going to go in the opposite direction. So I've got to go 4 more spaces to the left from the negative 3. So 4 more spaces to the left will get me to, I'm sorry, I should have written a 4 here. 4 more spaces to the left will get me to negative 7. Negative 7, once again, is the same answer I got the other way. Okay, so that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.